Welcome back everyone to another This Land Is My Land tutorial video. We're going to talk about fishing today. I know there's a few other videos out there, but we're going to go a little bit into detail like we always do. So first things first, you use the bow to shoot the fish. Now if you have a better bow, you get the more accurate shots. Something that they have implemented into the game is the distortion of the water level versus where the fish are actually at. So sometimes you have to shoot lower, sometimes you have to shoot higher, and again, the bow will also contribute to that factor. You can't use a gun to shoot the fish. A quick succession of shots generally helps, but the concentration perk is actually going to come in really handy here if you use it, and it's pretty well upgraded. You can get a lot more fish, and you don't have to use the one of the two perks as much. Let's get into that now. You have the Fishing 1 and the Fishing Mastery perk. So Fishing 1, if you don't get it and you shoot a fish, when you pick it up, you will get only the fish pieces. You won't get the whole fish. Once you get Fishing 1, you then can pick up the whole fish. And it works the same thing for the more rare fish. When you pick it, when you get Fishing 2, then you pick up the more rare fishes instead of just getting pieces. So I would suggest for the first tier would be the best to get early game, so that you can pick up most of the fish and use those for the recipes and not just their pieces. The second piece is the Fishing Mastery. Now this helps because you can shoot more at a time if you're in a close range and you can see them. A lot of times there's a glare and you have a hard time seeing the fish. I usually go fishing at twilight or at dawn when there's no sun and no glare there. And the Fishing Mastery just makes it so that each tier, there's a less of a chance of them scaring when you kill one or more fish around. When you get the fish shot and killed, they'll flop and you'll see a fish icon if you're close enough. Sometimes if you shoot them and they flop, that icon might go away if you go farther away, but it will still be there for a little bit. They do time out and despawn after a short while of either waiting in the same spot, or if you leave and you come back, they'll probably be gone. Again, when you're trying to pick them up, sometimes you have to crouch, sometimes you can just press F, sometimes you have to deep crouch and maybe even look at the tail or a certain part of the fish before you crouch to be able to pick it up. Oftentimes that's not the case. A lot of times I have to crouch to be able to pick the fish up. So let's talk a little bit about the fish types. Here you can see all of those as I go down. Something I've learned is that they tend to be regional. Each part of the map has different fish, and I haven't mapped that out pretty well yet, but it seems that some of the rare fish are only found in certain areas like the desert or the forest on your rivers there. Also, generally above a waterfall, and it'll be harder to find them above waterfalls is something else I noticed. Not impossible, but generally that's the trend that I found. The gather skills do not affect the amount of items that you get from the fish, so you don't get more meat when you cut a fish open or when you pick a fish up if you don't have Fishing 1 tier. The gathering or the hunting skills for your character don't affect that, so you don't get more. Now we've already seen a list of all of the fish, but here is a list of all of the recipes that you can learn and the ingredients that are in them and the bonuses for those. Now this could probably be its own video all by itself, and maybe eventually I'll make one, but it really is going to be dependent on your playstyle and the weapons that you use, so take a look in game and see which ones you will prefer to learn and build. That's about it for now, and as always, thanks for stopping by.